Okay, and welcome to part two on humanistic psychology. So we kind of left off with self-actualization and the needs, the components, the necessary components that make self-actualization necessary. So you can see, for as individualistic as Rogers was, he believed that interaction with others was pretty much essential for self-actualization, right? So self-actualization is connected to this necessity for growth. And these were the three. Now, this was connected to UPR, right? So this is what we really need in order to self-actualize: genuineness, acceptance, and empathy from important people in our lives. All right, now let's go a little bit further into Rogers, and let's talk about, they call his perspective, right? He calls it the person-centered or the client-centered perspective. So let's talk about personality. And we know in Freud believed that the personality was really comprised of these three components: id, ego, and superego, and the conflict between id and superego, and the ego trying to mediate between the two. And that personality emerges from those conflicts. Now let's look at Rogers. Rogers is really going to focus on one component. He's really not going to talk about it as a structure per se, but he's really going to talk about maybe a better way to put it is, like, he's going to focus on one idea or one concept. All right. And concept is kind of a giveaway: self-concept. So let's talk about how Rogers understands the self-concept, because it's a really, really important idea. So for him, he believes the self-concept can be either positive or negative. And the self-concept is how we feel about ourselves. And it dictates, it's kind of this awareness of who we think we are, how we describe ourselves, how we see ourselves. So this is how we see and describe ourselves. So an example might be, I'm shy, I'm outgoing, I'm open to new experiences, right? I'm easily intimidated, whatever it may be. Now, what Rogers believed was really the self-concept, whether or not it's positive or negative. So you're with me? Whether or not it is positive or negative is going to influence the way personality develops. Because remember, personality has to do with how I act, think, and feel. The more positive the self-concept, the more likely we will be to self-actualize. The more negative the self-concept, the less likely we will be to self-actualize, which will influence how I think, feel, and behave a lot about myself. Now, he comes up with real, I think your book calls it actual, real and ideal self. And the idea is, think about Venn diagrams. First of all, the real or the actual self, it necessitates and forces us to be honest with about who we are. So I don't want you to think Rogers is just pie in the sky. Like, you have to be honest about who we are, meaning our weaknesses, our strengths, etc. And then we all have this ideal self, the self we want to be. Rogers believed that the closer these two are together, right, so we have more overlap here, the more positive the self-concept would be. Because I'm coming closer to who I most want to be. The further away they are, the less positive, and hence the more negative, my self-concept would be. And this is going to result in problems for personality development if the self-concept is less positive. Okay, so we have what the self-concept is, right? It's this collection of beliefs, right, about who we are. Some examples, right? And you can see that part of our self-concept can be limiting. Whenever people say, I'm an English person, not a math person, that's part of your self-concept. And it's right there, you are limiting yourself, right? So self-concept can be positive or negative, right? And the two important components, the real or actual self and the ideal self, right, which we just went through. And the idea of congruence or incongruence. So congruence means these are closer together. Incongruence means they're further away, right? Which is really problematic. All right. So let me erase that. So the latter is when RS and R, and let me just erase that. I'm so sorry. There you go. So incongruence is when the RS and IS are not very similar. Okay. So let's put it all together. Self-actualizing is an innate tendency. Self-concept influences our personality. It will influence the way I feel about myself. It will influence how I limit myself. It will influence what behaviors I think I can engage in and which ones I can't. If the self-concept is more positive, I act, feel, and think more positively. It doesn't mean we're all identical if we have a positive self-concept, because remember, my self-actualizing tendencies are going to be different than yours. And the personality is influenced by this relationship, right? So, and then personality develops through experiences. The more experiences we have which encourage congruence, the more likely we are to develop a positive self-concept. And unconditional positive regard is what is necessary for this, one of the most necessary ingredients for this. All right. So there we have, right? Oh, sorry. There we have it. All right. So there's kind of Rogers in a nutshell for you. I'm going to end this screencast now. Good luck studying.